Hi there, Doug Stimon with IT Creations with a Supermicro IoT SuperServer 221HE-TNR. This 2U platform supports a number of applications, including cloud computing, telecom, micro data center, network function virtualization, and 5G core and edge. But that's not all, AI inference and machine learning too. So yes, on up to 3 double wide high performance GPUs. Seems like every server under the neon lights of a data center or server room supports AI in some way or another. Skynet anyone? If you like our channel, hit that subscribe button. If you're waiting for divine information to make that decision, good luck with that. Let's get to it. This 2U 6 storage bay chassis of the Supermicro IoT SuperServer 221HE-TNR server features dual 4th or 5th generation Intel Xeon Scalable processors with up to 64 physical cores and 128 virtual threads each. It also supports Intel Xeon CPU Max series processors with high bandwidth memory. The high bandwidth memory is the differentiating factor between standard Intel Xeon Scalable processors and the Intel Xeon CPU Max series, and better for data intensive applications like AI, high performance computing, machine learning, deep learning, that kind of thing. So if you are looking to support that type of workload, Intel Xeon Max series CPUs are apparently the go-to. The front of the system has 6 2.5 inch drive bays along the top and 6 large hot swap counter-rotating cooling fans below. Supported drive options include Gen 5 NVMe, SATA 3, and SAS 3. NVMe drives are split between processors. If you do decide to go all NVMe, you will need both. The control panel offers the usual complement of buttons and telltale LEDs. An on button, combo unit identification BMC reset button, then LEDs for power, drives, LAN 1, LAN 2, power fail, and general information. Are you interested in the Supermicro IoT SuperServer 221HE-TNR? If you are, then for a limited time, you can save up to $500 off the price that's listed or one that you can configure at IT Creations using our handy configurator tool. That's valued at $5,000 or more. Sweet, I know. The configurator tool is pretty cool. It will give you a running total on the cost of the system as you add components. You know, CPUs, memory, storage, maybe some GPUs. If you want to see more information on this server, click that link right there. When you're ready to make a purchase, just mention this video. Around the back of the system, you can see a generous allocation of PCI slots, but we'll get to that in a moment. Dual 2000 watt power supplies on the left, and beside those, two USB ports and a dedicated base management controller port. Then a VGA port and two OCP 3.0 card slots, or as Supermicro likes to call them, AIOM slots or advanced IO module slots. Those provide additional options for network connectivity, especially if you plan on installing 3 GPUs in this system. Using that dedicated management port on the back allows for remote management of the system using several management tools provided by Supermicro. Supermicro SuperCloud Composer allows you to manage your entire infrastructure in a customizable, software-defined, composable fashion. It's compatible with Redfish open standards, plus most third-party devices. Composer also allows for automation, alerting, and data analytics. With the addition of the Liquid Cooling Console module, or LCCM, it easily integrates with Supermicro's liquid cooling solutions. All of that through a single interface. The others, which you're gonna have to look up yourself, otherwise this video will take forever and never end. Moving on. Popping open the case, you can see 3 risers that can be used for network communications, hard drive controllers, or GPUs. There are x8 and x16 slot options depending on the intended workload. Either 8 PCI 5.0 x8 slots with 6 full-height full-length slots and 2 full-height half-length slots for 8 PCI slots total, or 4 PCI 5.0 slots with 3 of those at full-height full-length and 1 full-height half-length slot. That last option is for support of the 3 double-wide GPUs I mentioned earlier. There are quite a few GPUs supported on this system, including the NVIDIA RTX A6000, A5000, A4000, and A2. The A2 is a single width card, and with the A2, you can install up to 8 using all PCI slots in that first PCI option I mentioned. With all 8 PCI slots outfitted with GPUs, you will need to use the AIOM OCP 3.0 compatible mezzanine card slots for network communications. The NVIDIA A2 GPU is a single wide low power card designed for entry level inference. It only draws about 40 to 60 watts of power, which is available through the PCI slots. Featuring Ampere architecture with 16 gigabytes of GDDR6 memory, it uses a PCI 4.0x8 slot and does not require additional power connectors. With that low power draw and small footprint, it can find a home at the edge, in a data center, or the cloud. It doesn't have any outputs for monitor support and uses cooling provided by the server. In this case, those six fans lining the front of the chassis. In addition to that upfront storage, there are 2x4 slots on the system board for support of M.2 drives that can be used to boot the system. You can use a single M.2 drive or two that can then be paired in a RAID 1 configuration for mirroring, ensuring resilience if one of the drives goes south. Shrouds cover the memory modules for maximum cooling efficiency. There are 32 memory module slots total, with each processor in charge of 16 memory module slots. Both the 4th and 5th generation Intel Xeon Scalable processors support 8-channel memory architecture for 2 DIMMs per channel when fully loaded. At full capacity, this platform can support up to 8 terabytes of DDR5 registered DIMMs, running at speeds of up to 5600 megatransfers per second. With 5th gen CPUs, you can get a maximum of 64 physical cores and 128 virtual threads per CPU. With 4th gen, 60 physical cores and 128 virtual threads maximum. You also get 80 PCIe lanes per CPU for up to 160 PCIe 5.0 lanes in a dual processor configuration. And there you have it, the lowdown on the Supermicro IoT SuperServer 221HE-TNR. As an IoT server or Internet of Things server, it does offer support for GPU acceleration. Also good for the edge, data centers, the cloud, maybe a coffee table too, if you're really short on space. If you want to learn more about this system, I placed a few links in the description below. You can also use that one right there. Even a few links for NVIDIA GPUs and to IT Creations, itcreations.com. Until next time, dear friends, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations, and thanks for watching.